Hi everyone, this is a complete walkthrough video for the Employee Absence Tracker Google Sheets template. If you haven't purchased this template, I'll leave links in the description box below so you can go ahead and grab your copy. When you purchase this template, the first tab is an instructions tab. Here you'll find my contact information as well as a detailed step-by-step guide that will help you get started with using this template. For the rest of this tutorial, I will switch over to the demo copy of the template so you can see how it works. The first tab is the setup tab. The first column in the setup tab is for your department. So delete whatever is here and go ahead and type in whatever department that applies to your employee business. The next area is for your employee names. This template can hold up to 100 employees, but that can be expanded if necessary. After you have added your department to this column, you will now be able to assign a department to each employee. I'm going to delete this. And now I can assign departments to each employee. The first employee is in sales and marketing, the next one sales and marketing, finance, etc. If you need to add a new department that is not here, go ahead and add it here. And then when you go to the drop down section, it shows up right here. And if you need to delete, the same applies. Go ahead and delete. And then now reassign the employees to the available departments. The last area in the setup tab to edit is the absence key. The way the absence key works is that you will type in a letter code and then type in the word that represents the letter code. So I'm going to delete this and show you a few examples. So if I want H for holiday, for example, I would go ahead and type H and then holiday here. And if I want a PTO, I would assign P to PTO and type in paid time, etc. This template has been designed to only hold 6 slots. If you need more than 6 slots, you will need a custom template designed for you. I'm going to go back to the original entries to show you a little bit more about the absence key. Now, these colors that have been assigned to these categories carry throughout the template. So let me show you what that means. So vacation is this dark blue and sick leave is this reddish color. If I go over to January, you can see that vacation is always this dark blue color and sick leave is always this red color. And if you go all the way over here, where the key also shows up, that is consistent as well as being consistent here. And these shows up in every single tab in this template. And the reason why is because the template has been designed using a specific palette, meaning that if you want to change these colors, you can do that. However, please do not change the colors by changing them using any of the palettes here or using custom colors. If you do that, so for example, changing this from this blue to maybe this purple, it will not carry over throughout the rest of the template. So it's very important that you do not change these colors like so. The way to change the colors would be to change the palette directly. So go over to fill color, click on paradigm. Google Sheets does come with predefined color palettes, which you can use to replace this, or you can actually replace the colors with specific colors that you want. So once you open up the themes like this, it will show you the theme that has been applied to this template. Click done and it takes you to all of the colors that are available. So if I wanted to reassign this template to a different color palette, let's say I wanted to use this color palette, I'll click on it. And as you can see, the color automatically changes here. And if I go to January, you can see the new colors have been assigned correctly to the different key categories. If you want to use your own specific color codes, that's also possible. All you need to do is go back to fill color. Now we're going to click on this pencil button one more time. And instead of clicking done and going back to the color themes available, now what you're going to do is change the colors here. Reassign these predefined colors to whatever color you want. So if I wanted to change the first color, that's this dark blue color that's been assigned to vacation, to a purple, click on that. It changes it here as well as every single part of this template. So it's very important that when you change the colors, you are changing the colors here. The other thing I want to caution you is that the 4 colors 1, 2, 3, and 4, they are darker colors. So if there is text on that color, it has to be white. So if you look at this first color, 2nd, 3rd, and 4th, they contrast well with white text and not with dark text. So keep that in mind. And the last two colors would work with black text. I'll show you an example. So this is a dark color. If you really wanted to use a light color like so, as you can see, the text no longer have the contrast and it's not readable. You can go ahead and then change the text color to black. Select the area with the light color and change the text to black. To reiterate, do not change the colors here. If you want to change the colors, click on the color palette and edit the colors directly here, or click on and select one of these predefined color themes that Google has made available within Google Sheets templates. The next tab is the dashboard tab. I'm going to skip over this tab and show you how the monthly tabs work, and then we'll come back to it at the end. The way this template has been designed is that each month gets its own dedicated tab. So we have January all the way through December, meaning that this template can be used for an entire year. When the next year rolls around, make a copy of the template, change the dates, and you're good to go. Scroll all the way to the right part of the template. You can see that the date selected here is January 2024. Assuming you're going to use this template starting January 2025, all you need to do is double click and you can scroll all the way to January 2025 or change the date by typing in 2025 right here. I'm going to select January 1st, 2025. And as you can see, the dates now show up in order from the 1st all the way through the 31st. Now, there is the option to change the start date from January 1st. So if you wanted to maybe start January 15th instead of January 1st, you can see that the start date is January 15th and January 31st. Now, if you do want the next month, which is February in this case, to continue counting, you can click on this button and it flows into the next month. I do want to caution you that the data that shows up in the dashboard assumes that the entire month that says January only has dates in January. So if you're planning on using the dashboard extensively, do not use the template like this where you have dates from two different months showing up in one tab. You need to make sure you change the dates to January 1st and uncheck this box. If you don't plan on using the data in the dashboard, change the dates to whatever works best for you. The next part of the template I want to show you is that this section is completely hyperlinked. If you want to go back to the dashboard area, click on the dashboard tab and it takes you directly there. While you're in the dashboard tab, you can click on the January tab and go directly to January. Of course, you can navigate throughout the template by using the tabs below, but the option is available up here to make navigation more seamless. On this side of the template, you have a reminder for what the different colors represent and what the code represents, so V for vacation, S for sick leave, etc. And this is taken directly from the custom tab. So as you can see, we have V for vacation here, S for sick leave, which is exactly the same as what shows up here. If I were to change this to holiday, when I go over here, you can see that it changes to holiday as well. Every time you change the key and you have already made selections in this area, you will get this error message because the option that was originally there no longer exists. Now you have H instead of V. If you select H, that error message appears and the color that is assigned to H is restored. I'm going to delete some of these entries so I can show you how the template works from scratch. I'll delete the employee names and I'll go ahead and delete the entries right here. So we have a blank slate and the first thing is to click on the employee drop-down selection. Once I select an employee's name, a number and a department automatically shows up. So you don't have to type in a number or the department. There is a formula that automatically pulls this information from the setup tab. After we've selected the employee name, the next step would be to assign an absence category. So starting with the 1st of January, we're going to double click in the cell and select V. So assuming this employee is on vacation for 5 days, we can go ahead and assign vacation to the next 5 days. So all you have to do is double click and select an option from the drop down. So you can either double click to select or click in the cell, type the letter and make your selection. And then click on the next employee and do the same thing. Let's say I'm going to assign a third employee and I click on that. And instead of selecting this employee, I select this one that I have already selected. It turns a red color because it's telling me that there is a duplicate entry. So to remove that, just delete the employee name and select the correct next employee. Scrolling all the way back to the end, at the end of the template, we have a summary table. The summary table tells us the total amount of each category that has been assigned to these employees. So for employee number one, we have 6 vacation days, 4 sick days, 2 FMLA, 0 personal days, 1 bereavement, and 0 unscheduled absences. It also gives me a total of the number of absences as well as the percentage. This percentage is based on the total amount divided by the number of days in the month. So we have 13 divided by 31, which is 41.9%. If we go to February in this calendar for 2024, this percentage would be different. It would be 12 divided by 29 days. This formula takes into consideration the number of days that are in the selected month. And if you scroll all the way down, you can see the total number per category as well as the average percentage. And then you can move on to the next month, February, March, April, May, June, all the way through December. Moving on to the dashboard tab. The dashboard is divided into 3 main areas. The first area is for employee specific information. The second area is for all of the employees, so information, summary graphs, and charts for all the employees. The last area is summary information for all the employees, but in a list form. We'll get started with the individual employee area. First, we get to select the month. So right now it says June. I'm going to go ahead and change it to January. And it automatically shows January 2024. If you are using this in 2025, it would say January 2025 automatically. There is no data showing up here because this specific employee doesn't have any data entered in the month of January. So if I were to change this to Patel Priya, you can see the information specific for the employee shows up. This first chart shows you Patel Priya's overall absentee data for the month of January. As you can see, she had vacation for 6 days, which is about 46.2%, sick leave, FMLA, and bereavement. The next area is a table. It's the same data, but this is an easy way to quickly see the number of days and the percentage. This is the percentage of days absent for the month of January. The last graph here is the employee's annual absence overview. So we have the different categories showing up here, and you can see the January all the way through December overview. So just absent for 6 days for vacation, like you can see here, 4 days of sick leave, 2 days of FMLA, and 1 bereavement leave. And you can see the same data for the rest of the year. So for February, she had 1 day of sick leave, 5 personal days, and 1 unscheduled absence. This way, you can see the entire absentee data for that employee for the entire year. Moving on to the next area, you can see the first two graphs show the absentee for all employees for the selected month. So this month is January, so January shows up here. If I change this to February, the data changes to the data from the February tab. So the first graph shows you the absentee for all employees. So all of the employees for the month of February, you can see we had mostly vacations, then personal day absentees, FMLA, bereavement, etc. The next graph shows you the absentee for all employees, but by department. So you can see we had 2 departments with the most absentees, sales and marketing and finance. The next graph shows you the annual absentee category overview for all employees. So again, the same categories show up here, and you can see from January all the way through December, the number of vacations, the number of sick leaves, FMLA, personal day, etc. from January all the way through December in one graph. The next graph here is where you can actually view the number of absentee days for your employees, and you can filter by department. So right now we have sales and marketing selected. If I were to delete this, nothing shows up. So now we have to filter by the specific department. So if I click on admin, you can see nobody from admin had any absentees. So we'll go over to sales and marketing. You can see we had 374 days total for sales and marketing, and it is broken down by month. Customer service, we had none. Finance, you can see the numbers broken down by month and broken down by the different categories. You can see the numbers within each category graph and the sum of the numbers per month. Of course, August has the most days off, with most of those days being vacation. The last graph here shows the absentee overview for all the departments. So you can see here in this graph, we only have 2 departments. So I'm going to go back to the custom tab and reassign more departments so you can see how the graph actually works. All right, so now that I have added in more departments, you can see the absentees by department much better. So in January, for example, we had mostly finance and sales and marketing with days off. But in February, the highest absentee is from sales and marketing. So you can see 34.1%, finance 27%, customer service 16.5%, etc. That way you can get an idea of which department has the most absentees from January all the way through December. Moving on to the last section, we have 3 tables. The first table is the absentee data from today. The day of filming this video is the 25th of September, so this date shows up automatically. And if we were to go to the date for September 25th, you see we have 3 vacations and 1 personal day. So let's navigate over to the September tab and go to September 25th. And as you can see, we have 3 vacations and 1 personal day. So let's add a few more. Let's add 3 sick days. And if we go back to the dashboard, you can see we now have 3 sick days. So this shows you the specific data for the day automatically. So if you were to use this template tomorrow, the date will change to September 26th. And pulling data entered into the September 26th slot. The next table shows you your top 20 absence scores for the month you have selected. So March shows up here, and that's because March has been selected here. If I change this to April, this changes to April, and it shows you the top 20 absent scores that have been entered in the April tab. So as you can see, it goes from the highest to the lowest score. Diaz Gabriela has the highest score. So if we're to select her name here, you can see that her total absent score is 24, which is consistent with what we have here for the month of April. The last table is similar to the monthly table, but instead of showing you the score for individual months, it adds up the scores for the entire year. So it looks through all of the entries from January all the way through December. It adds the score and it orders it from the highest to the lowest score. That way you can easily see the highest and the lowest score for the entire year. That brings me to the end of this video. If you haven't purchased this template, like I said before, I'll leave links in the description box so you can go ahead and grab your copy. If you have any questions, remember my contact information can be found here. And finally, this template does come with a step-by-step guide that you can refer to while you are using this template. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.